I went from condos to pop's house, on calls now bus routes, and the one person who had the key to my heart took it and checked out.
So moving on a little bit, eventually at 18 years old, you ended up getting signed with Eazy-E, you know,
yeah,
with this record.
Yeah.
When did you meet Eazy, and what was it like being signed up under him on Ruthless?
Well, two of the homies from Watts, actually. That's the crazy part. Two homies from Watts. What happened was one of their nephews was in NYA with my brother Drayster. So he get out bragging about how hard my brother is on the mic, because he in YA doing talent shows and all this shit. So his name is ringing throughout the system. Big D, the homie, rest in peace, he get out, he telling his uncle, like, y'all got to hear this nigga Drayster, man, this nigga hard. And these are Eazy-E's partners. They grew up with this nigga. They used to serve in the street together, you know what I mean? So at this time, they was trying to transition from the street, and they was like, what better way to do it than start a label, get some talent, start a label, Eazy our homie, you know what I'm saying? And so one day, they pulled up on our street and was like, we heard y'all get down. We was like, yeah. They was like, spit something. We spit something. They was like, what y'all gonna be doing tomorrow? And shit, they came back, and my brother was home, I was gone, but they took the nigga to the studio. Yeah. He came back like probably about 4 a.m. that day and was playing all this music that he got with Eazy-E. I'm just in the kitchen like, hell no. He was like, we going again tomorrow, nigga, don't leave. So I waited around and shit, and they came the next day and went back, and they in there doing real motherfucking G's. And I'm just sitting there like, damn. I'm looking at Eazy because I'm like, this nigga little as a motherfucker. Like, man, you know how TV make you look big if you ain't never seen a person and shit?
Yeah.
So I'm like, damn, Eazy little as fuck. But it was just a crazy night, bro. That whole night was crazy.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I ended up on a song by accident.
Wow, that's crazy. That's crazy. Yeah. I mean, when it come down to that joint, I mean, let's just be real. One of the top five best diss songs to me ever is Real Motherfucking G's,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? You know
too.
When you had the, you know, the classic curl, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Wangsta Studio Gang, yeah. You know what I'm saying? And all of that, you know, when it come down to that, what led to that classic actually getting made? You literally made that the same night you met him?
Yeah, the same night. So they already was working on a song. So the way it is like my brother, when he write a verse for somebody, he'll go and lay it, you know, so the person will do it the way he, you know, he rhymed it and shit like that. So he already had his verses he laid before he came home, and Eazy had to learn them, and he had to go back in there and repeat them and spit them. So once he went in there and did his shit, there was a part of the beat, the part that I rapped on, that nobody understood how the beat extended right there. Because when they recorded it down the tape for my brother to take it home and write to, it wasn't there. So when we get back in the studio, now the beat is extended some kind of way. So they was figuring out, like, what the fuck we gonna do? Because it's three verses. You know, you usually have, like, an intro to a song.
Yeah.
And then you either have the hook or you start with the verse. But it's, like, usually three verses and two hooks.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So we ended up with four. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's how I got on it. But anyway, so that little part, they trying to figure out what they gonna do with it. And somebody in the studio was like, let that nigga go try something. And so I just went in there. I was just rapping all night, but none of the shit had to do with the song. So they was like, "Nah, man, come back out, man. You gotta talk about what we talking about."
Yeah.
Just went in there, got high. Went back in that motherfucker, and I just yelled that shit out, "Wah!" And that shit just came on my body, bro. And
yeah.
they was recording it. So
yeah.
They recorded it, told me to come out the booth, write it down, change these words and all that. And that's pretty much how it happened.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Now I know you young, you hungry, everything like that. You meet Eazy. We know you had no issues and stuff like that with Dre and you know other people that it was going against.
Hell no.
So how did you feel throwing like certain names up in there? Was it just like whatever?
I didn't even think about it, bro, because
yeah,
I was like, shit, this my opportunity. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like
yeah.
It wasn't even a thought in my mind, but I love Eazy just as much as I love Dre, because NWA as a group. It's like, you know, they my superheroes, you know what I'm saying? We from a little ass city in Compton, and for somebody to make it out of that shit, like on that level, bro, like that shit was amazing to me at 11 years old.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I just didn't care at the time because I was already streets. I was already gone.
Yeah.
You know?
Basically, if you was getting signed to Dre, would have been probably
absolutely.
The same thing.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely. Whoever would have took me, you know what I mean?
Yeah, real talk, real
yeah.
talk. I know there was an issue later that happened at a golf club with the dog pound up. Was
yeah.
it because of this song?
Well, yeah, that's kind of what started, because, like, every time we would run into them, bro, it would be, like, you know, that tension there. You feel
yeah.
what I'm saying? So what really happened, though, what led to the physical part of it, was Nate Dogg was on a golf cart, and he act like he was gonna run me over. And so, like, when he got close, he tried to swerve, you know, like he finna hit me, then swerve, but he still ran over my foot. And then I chased him, you know what I'm saying? I chased the golf cart. I'm like, nigga, what's wrong with you? He jumped up and started backing up. And he was like, get out of my face, little nigga. And I just fired, wow. And then, yeah.
With the golf club and everything, huh?
Yeah. But they the ones who went and got the golf clubs. First, they was like, y'all better get up out of here, because they started running towards their cars like they was finna go get some heat.
Okay.
And then came back with golf clubs.
Wow. Yeah. Crazy. Did y'all all ever make peace with that situation?
Absolutely, yeah. We super cool, yeah. We super cool now. Like, a lot of people had mediated that whole situation. Okay. Especially after that, you know what I'm saying? Because after that, it was going to be something different, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I had to show them that I wasn't made. I thank God for a second chance.